Welcome to all. I am Dr. M.R. Kadam, MSc in Analytical Chemistry and PhD in Material Science. Today we have seen the topic Sugar Industry. We all are well familiar with the sugar because this sugar is an important household constituent. This sugar is chemically known as sucrose, and the molecular formula of the sugar is C12H22O11. The sugar is produced from the two natural sources. One is beetroot and another is sugarcane. These beetroots abundantly grows in the temperate climate, while the sugarcane grows in tropical region. Today the major source of the sugar is the sugarcane. Now we have seen details about the sugar from the sugarcane. First we have seen little about the sugarcane. So this sugarcane belongs to the grass family. Sugarcane grows to height of 10 to 12 feet. Sugarcane contains about 9 to 12% of the sucrose. The agricultural laborers cut off the stalk close to the ground and removes the top portion and leaves, and the remaining stalk of the sugarcane is then transported to the sugar factory, where the juice from the sugarcane should be extracted before 24 hours, because after 24 hours, sugar gets inverted into the non-crystallizable glucose and fructose. And this glucose and fructose pass into the molasses without forming the crystals. The chemical reaction of this inversion is shown in this figure. So this inversion of sugar is also called as a hydrolysis, because this sugar undergoes hydrolysis reaction and forms D-glucose and D-fructose. Now we have seen the manufacture of white sugar in India. In India, white sugar is produced by the one-step process of the manufacture of white sugar. This one-step process consists of 5 steps. First, extraction of juice. Second, clarification of juice. Third one, concentration of juice. And fourth, crystallization of sugar. And last, fifth, separation of sugar crystals from the molasses. Now we have seen the extraction of the juice. The sugar cane received at the sugar factory is washed with water to remove mud and dust present on its surface, and then it is cut into the small pieces by using rapidly revolving knives. Then these small pieces are sent to the mill house. This mill house consists 1 2-rolled crusher and 3 to 4 3-rolled mills, which are arranged in series. Each mill have 3 rollers, and this each roller having dimensions 6 feet in length and 3 feet in diameter. The 3 rollers are placed at the 3 corners of the triangle. From this mill house, only these top rollers are rotating, while these bottom rollers remain stationary during the extraction of juice. A pressure of about 3 to 6 tons per square inch is maintained on each of the top rollers. There is also an arrangement to carry the cane chips from the crusher to the mills. From the mill house, which consists 4 mills, approximate 97% juice is extracted, as shown in this table. For efficient extraction of the juice, these cane chips are made soft by using the compound imbibition method. In the compound imbibition method, hot water is spread the cane chips from the third meal, and the weak juice of the third meal is piped to the cane chips from the first meal, and the weak juice of the fourth meal is then piped to the cane chips from the second meal. The juice collected from the first and second meal is then sent for the next step for the clarification of the juice. The pulp expelled from this mill house is the bagasse, and which is one of the important byproducts of the sugar industry.